Thank you very much, Dr. Priya Kannan. We have a couple of questions here. One from Dr. Shekhar. Pregnant medical and paramedical staff are given 3 months leave with full pay in the UK. Is there any such relief in our medical and paramedical staff?
Sir, we don't, all the pregnant mothers who are healthcare workers, about 28 weeks of gestation are recommended to go on leave. I don't know how everyone, we don't have a regulation or a guideline that we must do it, but it is recommended that they, after 28 weeks of gestation, to go ahead and abstain from work, sir.
Dr. Thirunavukar says, very informative presentation. I also say, very informative presentation. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Dr. Sandeep says, new guide, is there guidelines for umbilical cord stem cell preservation now?
As such, we know that we have sort of an idea. We don't know for sure that the viruses are not present in the placenta as of now. But then, yes, if there is a, if there is necessity to do it, you can go ahead. Of course, even the person who is collecting it, who comes from the lab, needs to have the precaution done. So, but for COVID, there is no special indication to go ahead for stem cell preservation.
Okay, Dr. Selvam, the need for social distancing within the house, please comment.
All mothers, because of their position that they can affect themselves or the baby, and if at all it is severe, can go in for preterm delivery, must have more severe social distancing than general population, and hence we recommend what we tell our patients is you be that they be in a separate room in which they don't move around the house and mingle with everyone at all points of time like others, but then they restrict themselves to a room and their food or everything can be brought there to make sure that we ask them to adhere to very strict social distancing as of now, especially when they are near term, about 28 weeks.
Dr. Dandapani, what chemoprophylaxis do you take? I think he means for the pregnant mothers.
Sir, we have not given any chemoprophylaxis as of now, but we only ask them to go for social distancing. We have not advised any chemoprophylaxis for them, sir, as of now.
You have good presentation comments from Dr. Manjunath Ramesh, Dr. Varguna Pandian, and Dr. Soundappan. Any other questions, please? Yes, what Dr. Selvam? Use of routine COVID-19 testing just before 20th week to consider MTP.
Sir, COVID positivity is not a criteria to go for MTP, sir. So, but if there is somebody who is going for MTP, because of any other causes, such as an anomaly or something, then just before, because it's a second trimester MTP, then they would be admitted to go through the procedure. In that case, just before admission, every patient is required to have a COVID testing done before they go in for a procedure. Hence, that would be recommended. But a COVID testing positivity is not an indication for an MTP, sir.
I have a question, Dr. Priya. Now that this COVID started, let's say in December, are there any papers which say a person who was pregnant at that time and then delivered by April, let's say in China or in America, are there any congenital abnormalities associated with this because of COVID infection in the 6th month or 7th month?
No, sir. Not yet, sir. Thankfully, not yet.
Okay.
Thankfully, it doesn't cause any congenital anomalies.
Second question is, in a patient who has just delivered a baby,
yes, sir.
I mean, keeping the mother and the baby separate is going to be one hell. So,
yes,
if
sir.
The mother is COVID positive, and
yes, sir.
How do you advise them to physically manage this situation? I mean, is it at all possible?
If we have to make it possible, sir, we recommend that the mother expresses her breast milk and then feed the baby with that. Rather than, it is a matter of 8 to 10 days, sir, for For example, we counsel them. The counseling plays a huge role here. We have to almost talk to them on a daily basis if that is the case. I look it as akin to situations where the baby is in the NICU for if it's a preterm delivery, and then the mother is in a different hospital, and we have to talk to her every day, keeping telling her how the baby is. The baby is there for a good reason for the baby. It is best for the baby. So we keep talking to her on a daily basis and counseling her. The same way in this also, but now every patient is very informative, sir. They are very, very well informed. They themselves call us and ask us, madam, do I have to really come in or can you explain to me on the phone? In that situation, if they know that they are COVID positive, they are. I'm sure the mother would be quite willing to just express the milk and give to somebody and the baby to be kept at a safe distance from herself.
Right. But when here the counseling
is the key. Talking to the patient, mother is the key, sir.
When we talk about breast milk, we know that certain maternal immunoglobulins get transmitted to the baby. If the patient, for the mother is COVID positive, do you think there is a chance that it will protect the baby from getting the COVID because of immunoglobulins or whatever? I mean, what do you surmise? Do you have any idea about it?
Maybe, sir, that is a possibility. But then when we see that there are patients who turned negative, but then recurrent in a due course of time turned again COVID positive, which was from China. We've also heard the news from China and also from South Korea. We don't know about how much this antibody thing is going to work for them. But if the breast milk allows some antibody to come to the baby, it will be good for the baby, sir.
Okay, there was also a news item in the, I think, Britain, the first four volunteers who came forward for vaccine development.
Yes,
one
sir.
Person has already died and three are fighting for their life.
Oh.
So vaccine is not coming out now.
Oh.
Dr. Manjula Nair has commended your presentation. Dr. Jyoti Basu says, good presentation by everyone. Admins can consider keeping CME through webinars only in future. We will definitely consider that. There are no more questions, Dr. Priya. Thank you very much for a very
thank
good
you,
presentation. All four speakers have done very well. We now have about 41 people present in this room. At the peak, we did have about 64. There have been a lot of hiccups at the start, during, as well as towards the end. And I think I must also get used to what is happening here. So members, whoever have suggestions, could you please WhatsApp me directly on my WhatsApp number? You know my numbers, of course, on the bulletin board. If you want to message, it will definitely reach me. So if you give your suggestions, and the next monthly meeting, we'll try to make a better job of it. Thank you very much. Nice of you, all of you to attend. We are sorry we cannot provide high tea on the house, but then you can all have it at your own houses. Thank you very much. I am now ending the meeting. Since I am the host, when I end the meeting, the room will close for all of you. So all of you may find yourself suddenly locked out. That would be normal. Once the meeting recording is done, I will share it with the web hoster partner that we have, and he will cut it into pieces and host it on our website. I think that should be possible only after the lockdown period has ended. I'm not very sure, but I'll try to get it done. Okay, thank you very much. Have a nice evening.